So have you ever seen drifting spots, cobwebs, or shadows in your vision? We call those visual floaters. And in this video, we're covering the three things that everyone needs to know about this common ocular condition. So let's take a look. Hey guys, this is Dr. Joseph Allen from Dr. Eye Health, bringing you the very best in tips and education about your eyes and your vision. And here on this channel, we do a lot of different vision product reviews, as well as educational videos just like this one. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And at any point throughout the video, make sure to check out the links and show notes below. We'll include additional information and anything else that we forget to mention today. I also wanted to give a shout out to my home base here at the Buffalo Eye Clinic where we're shooting today. If you live in the community, make sure to check us out if you haven't already. We're always happy to help. Now let's go over visual floaters. So visual floaters are actually one of the more common complaints that an eye doctor hears about every single day. And if you've never experienced them, they show up as little spots, almost like gnats or bugs that seem to drift or move out of our vision, as well as cobwebs that when you try to look at them, they seem to always drift and move out of your way, so you can never quite catch up with them. When these are a new experience for somebody, they can be pretty scary, right? Anytime our vision changes, or if something like we're getting spots in our vision, it kind of gives us that instinct fear that, hey, we might be going blind. And even with that being said, people tend to ignore coming in to see the eye doctor to get the professional opinion of what's going on. People just, they just don't know, they're ignorant about it, and they tend to just think, oh, it'll get better on its own. And then they're those same people that end up rushing into the clinic on like a Friday afternoon, right as the clinic is closing. And I don't want you to be one of those people. I want you to realize what's going on so that you can get it treated and taken care of right away. So let's go over my top three things you need to know about visual floaters. Number one is that floaters are a normal part of aging. You see, there's this gel that sits inside the eye. We call it the vitreous humor. And it takes about 90% of the eye's volume, keeps the eye's shape, and acts almost like a cushion for the eye in any sort of episode of trauma. And this gel actually degrades over time into more of a liquid. When that happens, the pieces of the collagen of the gel that are left start to form little deposits and strands, and they sit inside of that liquid. And that's what gives us that floating appearance as it kind of drifts back and forth. When light enters the eye and hits those deposits, it causes light to scatter, giving us kind of a shadow image onto the retina on the back of the eye. And that's exactly why we see floaters the way that we do. Again, floaters are a normal part of aging, and if you hit around the age of 60 or higher, you already have a 25% chance of having these floaters. And if you reach the age of 80, you're at about 66% chance. But it's not just due to age, there are some eye conditions that predispose you to having these floaters earlier on, such as being very nearsighted. Like myself, I'm fairly nearsighted, I'm about a minus 6. You can't really tell today because I'm wearing contact lenses. Because I have that higher prescription, my eye's a little bit longer. And with a really longer eye, the gel starts to degrade a little sooner. So that means I've had floaters for almost 5 years now, and I really don't notice them as much, except when I'm going outside and I look at a blue sky, or if I'm looking at like a white background, like on a blank wall. So I want you to realize that yes, floaters are generally a normal experience for everyone as we get older, and even more so for people who have a higher prescription. So that brings us to the second thing that everyone needs to know about floaters, and that's the risk of what's called a retinal tear or detachment. You see, that gel that's inside the eye has an outer layer that's made of more collagen. We call that the vitreous cortex, and it kind of acts like a shell, but it's attached to the retina on the very back surface of the eye. And as that gel starts to degrade and turn more into a liquid, it peels away from the back of the retina. And occasionally it can tug on the retina, typically in the outer edges starting off. And when that happens, it kind of acts like you're pulling onto a poster off of the wall. And it can actually cause a little tear, a complete hole, or it can even rip off the entire retina from the back of the eye completely. And we call that a retinal detachment. And that is a true ocular emergency. Now, sometimes there are no warning signs of a retinal tear or or detachment. But frequently when people come in, they start complaining that, hey, I have a sudden onset of new floaters, or, you know, there's all these new little floaters floating around and my vision's blurry. Or even they say that there's a bright flash of light in their eye off to their side, kind of like a camera flash or a lightning bolt. And that occurs because that kind of that peeling of the back of the eye from the retina causes a physiological excitation of the retina, and our brain interprets that as a flash of light. Now, if you're experiencing any of those signs and symptoms and you haven't talked to your doctor already, you need to pause this video. Call your eye doctor, make an appointment to be seen, because this can be the signs of that tear or detachment. And the sooner it gets identified and treated, the better the outcome. So don't put it off. You only get two eyes, take care of them. Additionally, because of those same peeling forces of the gel from the retina in the back of the eye, there can be some other complications, particularly when it comes to what's called the macula. The macula is the central part of our retina that gives us our crystal clear vision looking straight ahead. So if that gel starts to peel away from the macula, it can tug on the macula and cause the development of what's called macular edema, which are little cyst-like developments within the retina causing our vision to be blurred. And once it peels away, another serious consequence is the development of a macular hole, which is the same thing as the kind of the retinal hole off to the sides from the gel, except it happens in the central macula. So when you're looking straight ahead, you can no longer see directly what you want to look at. So it makes things very difficult for people to read or drive or see clearly. People may even become legally blind from that condition. Again, all of these different conditions that we mentioned can be identified and treated better when it's discovered earlier. So don't hesitate to see your doctor if you're having these symptoms. Get in now. So the third thing that everybody needs to know about floaters is the treatment options available. Now, I know I spent the last couple of minutes of this video explaining the risks of a retinal tear or detachment or other conditions. We're gonna bypass talking about those treatments for now. We'll revisit those in another video. But for floaters, there's generally three different treatments. One is, of course, not really much of a treatment, but more of just observation. Most people's visual floaters are not serious enough to require treatment. Yeah, they can be a little bit annoying, but over time, those floaters tend to drift down due to gravity and out of your field of view, or your brain just learns to adapt and get used to it to the point where a lot of people say, you know, I don't even notice the floaters anymore. Other people, though, these floaters can be really large and they can drift right in the front of that central part of your vision, and it can stop you from seeing the board correctly when we're testing your eyes, and it can prevent you from doing just, you know, your daily life activities that you enjoy. Even from things like driving or going to work can be difficult for some people. And those individuals are really good candidates for the other two treatments that are out there. Number one is what's called a vitrectomy. This is the oldest type of procedure that we have for correcting floaters. That's where they surgically remove the gel from inside the eye. They suck it out while simultaneously putting a new fluid inside the eye to keep the eye's shape and keep the eye pressure the same. With that, they remove all the gel, so all the floaters go with it. The downside, and the reason why many doctors don't recommend this procedure, is because there's a higher rate of complications. And so you're only a good candidate for that procedure if your vision is significantly affected by those floaters. The other option actually came out pretty recently. Really what's going on is that the development of a new laser procedure where they can zap away the floaters inside the eye. It almost reminds me of like playing the old classic arcade Asteroid game. So it was developed in Wisconsin by a surgeon who had been testing this out on patients, and you know, his success rate was incredibly high with a very low complication rate. With that being said, it still may not be beneficial for everybody because of the location of the floaters, maybe the severity, and other different eye diseases that you may have. But certainly different options you need to know about and consider discussing those with your doctor. So question of the day, do you have vitreous floaters, or do you have an interesting story about how you had floaters or maybe a retinal tear or detachment? Connect with us down below in the comments section. Love to hear what you guys have to share. All right, guys, thanks so much for checking out our video. Here on Dr. Eye Health, I'm Dr. Joseph Allen, bringing you the very best in tips and education about your eyes and your vision. If you want to check out more videos just like this one, go ahead and click the link over here to the side. Keep an eye on it. We'll talk to you soon.